All right. This is Mr. Peterson with another screencast for Earth Science. In this screencast, we will discuss fossils. So let's see what remains of the screencast. Before we get into more detail, let's look at what a fossil is. A fossil are the remains of evidence of a once living thing. Fossils give us clues about organisms that lived long ago. Through the fossil record, we can look at fossils over time, and it shows us evolution. We can also use fossils to show us how the climate and surface has changed on Earth. Paleontologists are scientists who study fossils. Most fossils are found in the sedimentary rock. Because we know how rocks are formed, we know that the fossils found closer to the surface are younger than those found deeper in the rock. We find the most fossils in the marine sedimentary rock. We rarely find fossils in igneous and metamorphic rock. How are fossils formed from the once living things, you ask? Well, first, the animal has to live and die. Once it dies, it is then covered by volcanic ash or sediment before it can fully decompose. The remains being covered helps prevent it from rotting away. Then more layers accumulate on top of the remains. Then minerals like silica slowly replace the calcium phosphate in the bones. Then, over a long period of time, tectonic plates push the fossil closer to the surface. When close enough, erosion or people digging expose the fossil for discovery. Fossils once found help to provide us clues on how the surface was changed over long periods of time. When paleontologists find seashells high in the foothills of the Andes, we know that the area was once very different. Either the sea once rose to cover the hills, or the hills rose up from under the sea. Either way, we know the surface here was once covered with the ocean. Fossils once found help to provide clues on how the climate of Earth has also changed. When scientists find evidence of fossilized coral near the Arctic waters, it is evidence that the water there was once much warmer. Scientists have found fossils of alligators in Canada. This gives scientists evidence that Canada was once a warm place. There are five main types of fossils. All five are pictured here. On the next slides, I'm going to talk more in depth about each one. First up is a petrified fossil. This means the bones of these animals were turned into minerals. This is, most likely, the kind of fossils you think of when you picture fossils in your head. Next is molds and cast. A mold forms when hard parts of an organism are buried and dissolve over time, leaving a hollow area with the organism's shape left in the rock. A cast forms as the result of a mold. Water, with dissolved minerals, just like petrified fossils, seep into the mold and leave minerals in the space left. This leads to a cast of the organism left behind. The third kind is carbon film. All organisms contain carbon. When it dies and is buried, all parts of it break down except the carbon. This can show delicate parts of organisms like leaves. Leaves normally break down much quicker than bone, but can still leave an imprint of the organism in the rock layers. The fourth is trace fossils. Trace fossils show the activities of organisms on land. As an animal takes a step, it can leave a footprint. The footprint can then be buried in layers of sediment and become solid rock, leaving an imprint of the footprint to be found by paleontologists later. The fifth type of fossil are preserved remains. Preserved remains are the remains of organisms that are close to the original states that they were in. There are three types of preserved remains. Amber is made from the sticky tree resin. As an insect lands, it becomes trapped in the resin and then covered up completely. The resin hardens, leaving an almost fully intact organism to be discovered later. The next type of preserved remain is tar. This is when an organism falls into a tar pit and dies. It soaks into the pit, and the tar prevents the organism from decaying. Last is ice. The cold temperatures prevent an organism from decaying if they die in a cold place. If the organism gets covered with snow that turns to ice, it can be preserved for a long period of time. Even its hair can withstand the time trapped in ice. Well, that's all I have on fossils for this screencast. Thanks for watching.